Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. A lot of friend of mine, they are asking me, how do I define professionalism? We often use the word professionalism, or he is professional or he is not professional. So I was thinking, what do we mean by the word professionalism? Because I see a lot of people in a very high operational positions, like CEO or the head of the department or head of the operations, or maybe the head of the, you know, different assignments. But when I look at their behavior, they seems to be expert in their skills. But when I look at their behavior with their subordinates, with their colleagues, with other people around them, I don't see them behaving very nicely and politely. So I was always thinking, how do we define professionalism? How do we decide whether the person is a professional or not? Then I went through a lot of books, and I, you know, read books on the different professional attitudes and behaviors. And here is my conclusion. Look, you see, the word professional and professionalism is derived from the word profession. And every profession has two aspects. One is operational and the other one is administrative. Operational aspect of a profession deals with the product. What product we are producing, what services we are offering. And the administrative part deals with the people who are managing that operation. So the people who are responsible to produce that product or services by managing operations, that part is known as administrative part. And the other part is operational part. So the word professional, if you exclude administrative part from the word profession, who is going to take care of the operational part, or who is going to take care of the quality of the product? It is always done by the people. So the profession, when we use the word profession, it is a combination of two processes. One is administrative aspect and the other one is operational aspect. Anyone who is considered to be a professional is a person who knows who is good in his skill, who can contribute in the process through his skill. And the second thing is who is responsible for the people. So the being a professional to me means that a person is, he knows how to behave with other people. He knows how to treat other people. He knows how to motivate other people so that they can remain focused and energetic on operational sides. People at the top, they are mostly responsible for the overall cultural environment of the organization. And cultural environment of the organization is built up with people. It is the people who decide what will be the culture. Their behavior, the collection of their behavior, the set standards of their behavior, that is what the organizational culture is. So if you treat people nicely and politely, and if you help them to solve their behavioral problems so that they can focus on the operational side of the business and make sure the quality of the product is nice or the services they are providing, that is nice. This behavior management so that they can focus on the customer and the quality of the product is known as professionalism. So the genuine professional to me is a person who is not only good in his skill, but he's also very good in his attitude. He knows manners, etiquettes, and behaviors. He knows how to solve people's problem. He is good in behavioral skill set, like he knows how to handle stress. He knows how to handle conflict. He knows how to speak properly with clarity and as well as with politeness and humbleness. So to me, anyone who is good in his skill but not good with the people, he's a technician to me, not a professional. So there's a lot of difference between professional and technician. Technician is only the person who is only good in his skill, but he doesn't know how to apply his skill through people. He can never be promoted as a team leader, because to be a team leader, you need to know how to handle people. So the people management skill basically is a behavioral aspect of your job. If you can manage a skill, that is easy, but managing people with different skills. So you're not only managing people, you are managing their skill set also. You're trying to make sure that their skill set, they don't have any conflict of roles, conflict of responsibility, and they are treating one another nicely and professionally, so that the original job for which they are hired, that is done with accuracy and with quality purpose. So to me, the word professionalism, or the professional, is the one who is not only good in his skill, but he's also good and in his behavior and attitude. So this is how I define the word professionalism. Clear?